Hi, I'm going to take you through the installation of the Maven plugin for Fortify SCA. As you might know, Fortify SCA has the ability to integrate with a number of build tools, including Maven. And these build tools can be found listed in the documentation located at microfocus.com/documentation. From there, you can find the Fortify SCA docs. And again, we have the documentation which talks about the Maven integration and installing this Fortify Maven plugin. So we'll go ahead and take you through this. We're going to assume that you already have the Maven installed on your system. I'm just going to verify that by running mvn space minus help, and I can go ahead and verify that I've got this installed here. So to find the Fortify SCA Maven plugin, I'll need to have also Fortify SCA already installed. I already have it installed on my system. If I go into the home directory for plugins and then Maven, I can find the Maven plugins. I'll find the source and the binaries here. And depending on what type of operating system you have, you may either want to use the zip or the tar.gz. Since I'm on Windows, I'm going to go ahead and use the zip. I'm going to install the Maven plugin source. So I'm going to extract this here. And once it's extracted, I can find the information about this. I can go ahead, take a look at the README. It has some information about how I can go ahead and install this plugin. So from here, talks about the two different plugins again, the binary version and the source version. Again, I'm going to go ahead and install the source version. These first steps are for the binary version. Here, I'm going to go ahead and run the installation for the source version. So to do this, I'm going to go ahead and navigate to the directory where this plugin is located, and I'm going to run this mvn clean install command. So I'm going to take this directory, I'm going to head over there. So again, this is my SCA installation directory, navigating all the way down to the plugins and ultimately where I had extracted that source zip file. From here, I'm going to go ahead and run mvn clean install. And this will start installing the Maven plugin for SCA. So now I'm in the directory where I've extracted the Maven plugin source. Again, this is from the zip file that I had extracted into this directory. So what I'm going to do now is, following the README file, I'm going to run mvn clean install to go ahead and install this plugin. Something that you'll notice here as well is that we're going to start pulling down some files from the Maven Apache site. Okay, now that our Maven plugin is installed for Fortify SCA, we can test it out with some sample code. So in the directory, there is a samples directory. I'm going to go ahead and take a look at this RabbitMQ. And there's README, which you can open up and take a look at how to scan this. So there's a couple of things that we want to make sure. We just want to make sure that we have the right path set for Source Analyzer for Fortify SCA and also for Maven, and then we can run this help command just to make sure that everything is proper here. So I'm going to go into the samples directory first, and then I'm going to run Source Analyzer minus V, just double check the version of Fortify SCA that I have installed here. And this comes back that I have 1910 installed for Fortify SCA. And then I'm also just going to double check my Maven version. So I've got 354 installed here. So the next thing that I'm going to do is just make sure that the plugin is properly installed. I can run this MVN with the help command to run this. Just going to clear my screen a little bit here just so that you can see this better. Okay, so this successfully came back. So now I know that I have my Maven plugin properly installed for Fortify SCA. So from here, what I can do is I can go ahead and run a scan on this sample code here. And to do that, what I can do is I can actually run this script, this direct invocation, either .bat if I'm on Windows or .sh if I'm running this on Linux. But if you want to actually see what's happening here, let's just go ahead and open this up here. So we'll run these commands manually just so that you can see what we're doing here. I'm going to open up this direct invocation.bat. So I'm going to start first by running this MVN clean here. So notice here, I'm actually not in the proper directory. Move from the samples directory over to this simplistic RabbitMQ. Yep, so from here, I'm gonna run the MVN clean. Okay. Project's clean. We go ahead and run the clean also for SCA in case I may have had, even though I haven't scanned anything here, but if I did previously, I may have a build that I may want to clean up and start the scan again. So I'm going to go ahead and run the clean first. So we've had build success here. Go ahead and run the translate. So at this point, what we're going to do is we're going to run the translate the code to the normalized syntax tree. Okay, so once the translation has completed successfully, you should see a build success here. And at that point, we're ready to scan for any security issues here. And this time what we'll do is we'll run the command with scan. So this time, we're going to go ahead and scan. Okay, once the scan is done, you'll actually be able to find it. It will be in the target folder. So where your project is, go to target, Fortify, and then you'll find the FPR file here. You can open this up into Audit Workbench, and you can see the results here. So I'm going to change to the Security Auditor view, and I can see the issues that I found here. So just to recap, there are two ways to run the Fortify Maven plugin. The way we've run it today is as the plugin specifying MVN, and then the plugin can optionally specify the version and then the command. So we ran the clean, we ran a translate, and then we ran a scan. The other way that you can run it is as a build integration. So in this case, what you would do is specify source analyzer minus B, specify the build ID, and then specify MVN and the commands that you would run for MVN. For example, this one runs MVN package after. And again, this is all documented in the Fortify SCA user guide.